All I ever knew about food from Zacatecas was the food that I grew up with, like enchiladas, tamales, gorditas, pozole, y tacos. It wasn't until we visited the city of Zacatecas that we learned about other traditional kinds of foods from here, like asado de bodas, tacos envenenados, and caldo de rata.
Huh?
Yes, you heard that right. Rat soup, caldo de rata. I'm Jenny with Eat Baila Travel, and welcome to our food vlog on Zacatecas. Start this vlog with the traditional foods that we're familiar with and the ones that you can find in most restaurants in Zacatecas. Then we'll move on to the new foods that we have never heard of and we just might be brave enough to try el caldo de rata. I don't know though, will we? Enchiladas are one of Mexico's most iconic dishes and different states in Mexico have their own version. So today we're gonna start with enchiladas Zacatecanas at Cocina y Churrería Nacional. As soon as you enter, you could smell the cinnamon sugar and the churros. It's smoky. I think that might be why. When it comes to the fancier restaurants in Zacatecas, this one I think is one of the most affordable because they offer a variety of packages for your food. They've got breakfast packages, lunch packages, and dinner packages. And it doesn't really matter the time of day. It's lunchtime, but I asked for the dinner package. It comes with sopa nacional, que es la sopa azteca. Then for your main plate, an orden de tacos or enchiladas Zacatecanas. I chose the enchiladas Zacatecanas. And you can also get a churro with some sort of topping and a coffee or hot chocolate.
I went with the tacos de ranchera just to switch it up a little bit so that we can both share. And they are fire. They're so good. Homie salsita. Enchilito, shout out to my sister-in-law Elena. She loves to eat these. So I'm having some in your name.
Taco. I wasn't sure what to expect with enchiladas Zacatecanas because I've never ordered them at a restaurant before, but I should have known because as soon as they set the plate down in front of me, I felt like I was at home. I was like, oh my gosh, these are my mom's enchiladas. And of course we never called them enchiladas Zacatecanas. They're always just enchiladas. And they're made with a special guajillo sauce made with the chile guajillo, which is an abundant chile here in Zacatecas. You can order them with chicken or with cheese, and I asked for a combo. Ooh, it's the cheese one. It really does taste just like home. Funny, right? I'm in Zacatecas, where these are from, and home for me is Chicago. It's really nice and warm. They made this fresh.
From enchiladas Zacatecanas to enchiladas Suizas, there's no better place than Taqueria Wendy.
So we're at Taqueria Wendy per a recommendation on Instagram. We came to check out las enchiladas suizas, and we also ordered las enchiladas mineras. We wanted to order enchiladas mineras to see how they differentiate from Guanajuato, and they're completely different. When they bring me the plate, I was kind of surprised because the salsa that they put on top of it reminds me so much of the salsa that my mom puts on flautas, so that made me really happy. Then we have the enchiladas suizas. I'm anxious to try this because it looks a lot like the salsa my mom makes with flautas. So we're gonna give it a shot. Very close to the salsa my mom makes. Except my mom's salsa has a lot more rajas. They're good though, they're really good. If you haven't checked out our Guanajuato video, check it out so you can tell the difference between las enchiladas de Zacatecas y las enchiladas de Guanajuato. They are also known as the enchiladas mineras. So our friend on Instagram recommended las enchiladas suizas. So this is what we came for. You recommended, we came to taste it. It looks like it's a salsa made con jalapeño, which is different. Normally the enchiladas that I've seen, they're like kind of like crema. It's still crema based, but it looks like it's blended with the jalapeño. Oh, hell yeah. So full, but these are the best enchiladas suizas I've ever had.
for some ice cream?
No, vámonos.
Right around the corner from Wendy's Taqueria is an ice cream truck at the Monumento for Mineros Zacatecanos. Nieves La Ermita de Jerez are a local favorite ice cream chain with fresh made fruit syrup toppings like jarabe de fresa or jarabe de guayaba.
Fresa, which I ordered from my mango. And you kind of just, you know, try to make sure you don't get it all over yourself. In case you're sleepy, tired, levanta muertes.
Alright, give me my ice cream.
Then there are tunas. No, not tuna fish. Tuna, the fruit of the desert, the prickly pear. Nopal cactus is abundant in Zacatecas and so is its fruit. Tunas are a local favorite for its nutrition benefits and succulent flavor. It's high in antioxidants, vitamin C and B complex, and fiber. And yes, the seeds are okay to eat.
A food blog on Zacatecas is not complete without a section on wine. Now, this is just gonna be a teaser because we're working on something much bigger than just talking about wine in a food blog. We are working on a research project to investigate why, despite having the oldest winery in the Americas and being Spain's first major colony, why isn't Mexican wine more popular? Or why isn't Mexican wine a leading competitor in the wine industry? The wine is really good. So it's not about quality that's an issue. So we'll be investigating and answering those questions while exploring the different wine regions in Mexico, but we could really use your help and support to make this happen and to make this really good. If you'd like to support us and this project, please visit the link in the description below for buymeacoffee.com/ebailatravel, and you can buy us a glass of wine or two. Any and all donations will not just go to literal glasses of wine, but to the cost behind the field research that we will be conducting throughout this process. We will invest as much effort as necessary to make this a really good project that will hopefully one day even influence the Mexican wine industry. By the way, as you're exploring food in Zacatecas, be sure to pick up a few dulces típicos from any of the street vendors. I got a dulce de camote and a queso de tuna. Yes, prickly pear cheese, it's not really cheese. And of course, get yourself a bottle in any of the shops in the downtown market and enjoy with your dulces. Cheers. We began planning for this vlog with a short list of foods, but the more time that we spend here, the more we realize that there are really cool things that we want to show you, like the caldo de rata.
But first, we want to take you to one of the most fascinating restaurants in Zacatecas City, La Leyenda Restaurant and Bar.
We chose to eat here because we heard that it's not only a delicious restaurant, but it's basically an art gallery within a restaurant.
At first, this traditional place opened with a concept of birria and tequila. Currently, it's a gallery that hosts over 10,000 art items. At La Leyenda, you will see works by artists from Zacatecas and from other parts of the country and Latin America, which make this restaurant a unique concept in the city. But in addition to appreciating the art collection, its cuisine is also a good reason to visit.
Here you can try some of the famous local dishes like asado de boda. It's called wedding stew because it's a popular dish served at weddings. It tasted a lot like mole, but instead of chicken, they use pork. Since I'm trying to cut down on my pork consumption, I wasn't a huge fan of this, but the mole sauce was delicious.
All I can say is that this restaurant is super unique. It's one of those that you have to come and experience for yourself to be able to understand the magic of it. The more you look, the more you see. There's art everywhere, even in the bathroom, in the floor. It's quite a sight for the eye. What is that?
Another famous local restaurant is Acropolis. This is another restaurant slash art gallery, but it's a famous cafe right next to La Basilica.
Acropolis was founded in 1943 by a Syrian immigrant who moved to Zacatecas and sought to established the first family-friendly cafe in the city during a time where bars and cantinas were everywhere. Since then, this cafe is recognized by both locals and visitors as one of the most iconic places in Zacatecas. Current place any time of day, they're open from 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. So we're here for breakfast because they have amazing bolillo with salsa, coffee. Because it's the oldest cafe in the city, their coffee is amazing. And we also got some huevos borrachos. Oh, I'm so hungry.
It's coffee time. We visited a lot of cafes in Zacatecas because of the chilly summer temperatures, usually in the low 60s, even in August. This weather made us crave lots of pan dulce too, so if you're a pan dulce lover like us, be sure to stop by Panificadora Santa Cruz. It's a panaderia on one side, but on the other side, they serve coffee, crepes, lattes, and more. Midali Cafe was a great space to work during the day, and their cappuccinos and chai lattes are amazing. Can you tell that we really enjoyed indulging in our sweets here? So much comfort food and desserts. Speaking of comfort food, don't miss out on the tamales and atole from the street vendors. Next up, tacos, of course. If you're a fan of Al Pastor, you definitely won't want to miss tacos from La Tosca. At 10 tacos for 59 pesos, it's already a good deal, and on top of that, they're delicious. The meat absorbs the sweet flavors of pineapple and cinnamon. So scrumptious. Oh, and if you like a little crunch, the volcanes are great. Replace the soft tortilla for a crunchy tostada and add a layer of that grilled cheese and voila, a cheesy volcano. But the star of the show here is la quesuda de pan. It's like a torta, but more, with layers of grilled cheese inside and on top.
This is the only torta in the world that I have seen that is allowed to be eaten with a fork and a knife.
The next taco is the famous poison taco, el taco envenenado. Let's find out if there's really poison in this taco before we try it.
Taco dorado.
Dorado. Bueno, así queda de este tamaño.
Así está bien.
Sí. Lleva esta partita que está hecha a base de frijol, papa, chile, chorizo, condimentos y especias. No es picosa. A esa pastita le podemos poner bistec, que es bistec encebollado. O ambos, bistec con queso. No llevan verdura, solo llevan sus chilitos toreados y sus salsitas. Y ese es el taco envenenado.
This is my first taco envenenado, so let's hope it's not going to be my last. I got a plain one. Kevin got one with bistec. And they're really crispy. They almost remind me like the Taco Bell ones. It's like it's a real fried tortilla, not like a fake thing. So we have some salsa. Que sabe esto.
It's a secret.
So what do you guys think the secret ingredient is? Better not be rats.
El taco envenenado en Zacatecas de hecho es el platillo más típico aquí de la ciudad. De la ciudad, no del estado, de la ciudad. El taco envenenado surge a raíz de una persona. A finales de los años 50, se le ocurrió hacer una especie de mezcolanza, ¿no? De un taco diferente, se le ocurrió hacer y inventó esta pastita. Entonces, al momento de que inventa esa pastita, él hacía sus tacos y empezó a hacer unas tortillas, él corteaba sus tortillas, las doraba y se iba a venderlos a la estación de ferrocarriles. En aquella época, como ustedes saben, pues era el principal medio de transporte, ¿no? So, él llegó con sus tinitas, llevaba unas tinas con sus tacos dorados. Y allá, entonces la gente llegaba y le preguntaba, que de qué eran sus tacos. Pero este señor era muy renegado, muy corajudo de aquella época, ¿no? Personas muy fuertes. Entonces él le daba mucho coraje y le preguntaba, entonces decía, son de veneno si me quieres comprar. Y dice, no, ya sin ni imaginar lo demás. Entonces, eso fue trascendiendo cada vez más, hasta que la gente empezó a bautizarlos como envenenados por la frase que decía este señor.
It is embarrassing how quickly I devoured that thing. I'll be honest, I'm not a huge fan of fried tacos or tacos dorados usually, but man, that was actually really good. That was not your typical fried or taco dorado. Definitely, definitely a must try when you visit Zacatecas. And specifically, I would say this spot, because although we haven't tried many other places, we asked around, we did our research, and we talked to the cook and the owner. So based on our very scholarly research, we highly recommend that you come try Tacos Envenenados here at Taqueria Abastos.
I know we promised caldo de rata, but first we'll need some liquid courage to prepare for this food challenge. We came to the oldest cantina in Zacatecas for a shot of amargo. This amargo liquor is a mezcal that is aged with some herbs for several months. Miners in Zacatecas used to drink this after a long shift at work. They believed this drink would cleanse their throats from the dust in the mines. Personally, we didn't like it at all. It reminded us of Malort back in Chicago.
Sabe sagrado, así como que le pusieron incienso ahí. ¿Quieres probarlo?
It turns out that the herb used to make the amargo liquor is very similar to the wormwood herb used to make malort.
¿Te gustó?
¿Alguna vez has probado caldo de rata?
No.
No.
¿Lo probaría?
No.
¿Lo probaría?
No, porque iba a probar. No. O sea, yo sé que es nutritiva, pero nah, no, guácala. Primero okay. Me muero.
¿Alguna vez has probado caldo de rata?
No, nunca lo he probado.
¿Y lo probarías?
Sí, dicen que luego no es tan malo.
Okay. ¿Alguna vez has probado caldo de rata?
No.
¿Y lo probarías?
No.
¿Por qué no?
Guácala, no mames. Son ratas de alcantarilla. No, no, no probaría.
All right, so let's see what this is all about. Before trying the caldo de rata, we had to ask the owner of this little comedor for some background.
Bueno, acá en todos los ranchos se acostumbra mucho lo que es la rata, la víbora, el conejo, los animales de rancho. Las propiedades de la rata es porque se alimenta de hierbitas, mija, de pura hierba, igual que el conejo. Por eso es que tiene muchas propiedades para el cuerpo benéficas. Se alimenta de puro sano, de la hierbita de los nopales, de las raíces.
¿Y los tienen todos muy controlados con una granja o con
una granja? No, eso es en el campo, mija, se da todo se da en el campo.
¿Son silvestres entonces?
Sí, pero en el campo, como el conejo. Todo libre. No, para cazarlas, pues sí utilizamos trampas para cazarlas, pero desde hace miles de años se utiliza todo eso en los ranchos. Aquí en la ciudad pues sí se desconoce todo eso, ¿verdad? Pero en los ranchos no, es una maravilla. Y comerlas en chilito rojo, en caldo, en salsa, igual que el conejo asado.
It's so crazy to me that this caldo de rata is such a common thing in the ranchos in Zacatecas. Because my mom is from a rancho in Zacatecas and she's never mentioned it. Obviously, it's not something she would cook for us in Chicago because we can't get the same like field rat. I'm super curious if she ever had this when she was young. So I'm going to call her and ask her and see what she says. See if she answers.
Andamos en un comedor donde. Donde preparan un platillo muy típico de los ranchos de Zacatecas y te quería preguntar si lo conocías tú.
¿Qué platillo es?
Es caldo de rata. ¿Tú lo conoces o lo has comido antes?
¿Caldo de rata?
Caldo de rata. Ajá. ¿No? ¿No? Es una rata de campo, es rata limpia. Pero no... ¿Sí?
Aunque sea rata linda, yo no me la como, pero porque...
No. ¿Pero sí se comía en el rancho? Bueno, dicen que es muy curativa y muy buena. No, apenas ahorita la voy a probar. Ah, ok. So mama approves. Thank you, ya tengo tu bendición. Ahí me mandas una bendición por teléfono para que no me pase nada.
Ahorita
que
ahorita sube al grupo
del platillo
y luego ya te mando
el
beso.
Okay.
Aprovecho.
Ajá.
Okay,
mami. Thank you.
Are you serious
to get a movie? Yes. I mean, it's all mental, right? Like, it's just the idea that we have of rats is like city rats, like gross alley rats. But these are not those. So I'm just trying to remind myself to think back to the time that I tried rabbit for the first time, or the first time I tried cuy in Peru. It's the same idea, same concept. This is like, she explained that this is a clean rodents from the mountains, so there's no reason why anything bad should happen to me. It's like, it's all mental. I just gotta get over that thought. Let's see if I can do that. But don't think I'm doing this alone. I gotta play for you too. Okay. Esta es pierna. ¿Y esta parte qué será?
Parte del
tórax,
chica.
Okay, so like, okay. It's like the belly, like up to the throat, like this part. I don't know what my rat anatomy is. This looks like a butt. Is it? Okay, and then we have
You gotta prepare it, but you gotta put some stuff on it.
Okay, yeah. I'm gonna put some stuff on it. Let's put some limon. I love limon. Got veggies, got some calabacita, repollo, papa, zanahoria. It's already healthy. Alright, we got a little pack of tortillas too. Am I the only one that likes to add limon to all my food? Even the tortillas. I'm gonna make a little taquito de salsa just to, you know, in case I need a chaser or something. Well, and then I can add some stuff to this, so I have some onion, some rice, because cual caldo no lleva arroz, y el hecho de limón. Alright, I'm gonna... Why don't you go first? Why do I have to go first?
This is a Zacatecas experience.
I'm gonna try the caldo first, because there's less pressure in that. This is like any vegetable.
There's less.
No, put some rice.
That's stallion. Please,
alright, here we go. I'm going all in. With his leg. Oh,
just the fuck, just the idea of this is gross. Your skin is really chewy, but it's good. It's good. It's almond though.
Taquito de rata.
No, it's really, really good.
Esto no es pierna entonces.
No, ese es el lado de la columna, mija. Okay. De la columna, de aquí y de las costillas. Okay. De ese lado.
I'll try some ribs. It's actually pretty good. Wanna try some ribs? This lady was super nice. So even if you don't come here to try the caldo de rata, definitely visit her spot because she has 22 different guisados. She can make you gorditas, tacos, and she has a variety of other foods. So don't miss out on her amazing food just because you're grossed out by the caldo de rata. But if you're brave enough, try it out. Let me know in the comments if this is something that you'd be down to try. These rats, they only eat the herbs and the leaves in the mountains. So she emphasizes that these are clean rats because they eat clean. But in the end, this is a really good dish and really good for you. I know we're going here, but doesn't that food truck with the tables on top look amazing? What a genius idea. We're here because there's a bar that has an amazing view of the inside of the plaza. So hopefully it's not too late and we can get in. Well, this is pretty cool. I mean, as a hotel on its own, it's really nice. But then you look on the other side, and it's an actual bull ring. Oh my gosh. Wanna crush the wedding? I don't think anyone will say anything, right?
When you're dressed up like that, yeah.
I bet you. No better way to end a food vlog than with a little digestif. I feel super grateful for the opportunity to explore the foods of Zacatecas, including ones that I knew and new ones, especially cool experiences like the one at this Plaza de Toros. Highly recommend coming for the drinks and the view here. Cheers to you. Cheers to Kevin for being such a great partner. Y nos vemos en la próxima.
Ciao.